storyboard, this is Shibani Gharat. Earlier this year, Chief Executive Worldwide Ogilvy John Seifert announced that the agency would be undergoing a restructure, which he dubbed as the agency's next chapter. A 39-year veteran of this agency, John was recently visiting India, and we spoke to him about the new structure for Ogilvy and what will make talent stick to the agency just like he did. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Great to be with you.
So let's start with something new. You created a new structure and purpose for Ogilvy. What were the factors, in fact, that you took into consideration while creating this new structure for the agency?
Well, we really did it. We started with clients. Clients wanted us to be simpler, less fragmented. They wanted us to work more collaboratively with them. And they wanted to get the best of the agency, from creativity to client service to production to data and analytics. They just wanted it to come together far more seamlessly. And we had become, over time, quite fragmented. We had many different brands in the agency to define all these different capabilities. And so we'd really kind of lost touch with what clients were asking of us. And so they are the reason that we're really, we've completely rethought and redesigned the agency structure.
So it has been a couple of months since this whole restructuring and redesign. How have clients taken the whole restructure so far?
Well, the good news is we're winning new business. So we're winning clients now on the basis that they see that we can serve their whole brand needs. So not just brand strategy and advertising, but everything that goes into their marketing and communications that ultimately leads to a sale or to a higher level of reputation. So clients have been very responsive. It's worked in new business, and current clients are now much more interested in talking to us about how we can reshape ourselves around their, you know, very dynamic needs.
What about the employees? How have they taken the new structure?
Well, most of the employees, so I'm in India for 2 days, and I will tell you it's one of the most inspiring visits I've ever had. Because initially employees thought, well, I'm gonna lose something, I don't manage a P&L, I'm not in control of my own part of the agency. Everything I saw for the last 2 days was a group of people who were finishing each other's sentences. They were working together, they were highly collaborative, and there was a sense of team like I've never seen before. So my sense is that once we get over that sort of initial period of this is different, I'm not really certain if I'm gonna personally like it, once they experience the changes that clients show in the fact that it serves them better, employees will get on board.
So, you know, we are often seen asking this question to a lot of brands and marketers, that what was that marketing problem that made you make that structural change or the change within the campaign or the strategy? To you, if I were to ask you, what was that problem that made you restructure, what would that be?
Well, I think it was we were just too complicated. So clients were telling us that we were too cumbersome, that we were too slow. They didn't know exactly who did what. They didn't really understand the totality of our offering. And so I think the single simplest way to answer the question is we were just too complex. We were confusing our clients. And in a way, I think we were losing business as a result, because they were starting to find either specialists who they thought could do things that Ogilvy couldn't, or they just felt that we were too expensive and too slow to work with in an incredibly dynamic time in their life cycle. So really, at the end of the day, complexity was the fundamental problem.
Okay, as I said, you are one of the oldest hands.
You're telling me I'm old.
39 years for an advertising agency is a really long time, especially for an advertising industry. How have you seen your agency changed in these 39 years, and what are the changes that you have seen personally?
Well, you know, one of the benefits of being in one company for 39 years is you have a front row seat to all the change. And I started at a point when in the late 70s, when David Ogilvy was still literally running the company and was a huge influence on me, all of his values and beliefs, his point of view about brand building. That's what really got me so excited to come to the agency. And then I stayed for 39 years because I had unbelievable mentors from all parts of the company.
Okay, in an era where retaining talent and hiring great talent is like the biggest challenge for this industry.
Definitely.
Coming from a person who has stuck to an agency for 39 years, how do agencies do that? And how do agencies solve this problem?
It's never been harder. In fact, I just, before coming to see you, I spent the last hour and a half with our India team talking about nothing but talent. You know, there's a few things. One is you have to give employees, particularly the youngest employees, a sense of purpose. You know, they don't just come because of the nature of the work. They want to know what the firm believes, what its values are, what it thinks, what its place in the world is. So purpose really does matter more than ever. Our redefined purpose of making brands matter is something that we're incredibly excited about. We think it's incredibly true to what David Ogilvy started, but it's even more relevant now in a world where some people question the value of brands, and our brands as important going forward as they have been in the past. So we're really excited about, you know, what we think our purpose stands for. The other thing we have to give our people is a sense that we can look at their careers over years and give them the learning, the experiences, the tools that they know they will need to compete.
You know, Ogilvy has lost a few talented people over the past few months, especially Tham Kai Ming.
Yeah.
What did Tham Kai's exit mean for Ogilvy?
Well, I mean, it was an unfortunate situation where we parted ways under a difficult set of issues. But we thought we made a decision that was true to our values and true to what we believe in and what we promise our people in terms of what's expected of them. I wrote in the note when Kai left that, you know, we ask every employee in the company to sign a code of conduct every single year. And there's nobody too senior or too important to not be held accountable to that code of conduct. And so while it was unfortunate and sad for us, I feel as though we made a decision that was very important for our brand and the promise we make to our people.
Okay. Ogilvy, also, you know, whenever I used to have like this final day conversation with Sir Martin Sorrell on, the last day of Cannes Lions every year, he would speak of Ogilvy very highly and, as an agency setup, as a creative powerhouse. What did Sir Martin's exit from WPP mean for Ogilvy and for you as a person?
I lost a boss. Martin, I've known Martin since WPP acquired Ogilvy and Mather back in the late 80s. And I started working for Martin when he asked me to become the chief executive of Ogilvy nearly 3 years ago. He was unbelievably supportive of me throughout my career. So Martin, it for me, is a loss. But that said, WPP is so much bigger than one person. And I think what we've learned since Martin has left is that WPP has amazing talent, amazing capabilities. It has to evolve and change for all the reasons that, you know, have been well reported. Lots of new competitive pressures, more demanding clients who are looking for more value for their agency services. And I think we now have a new leadership team who is totally committed to doing whatever it takes to make WPP better and stronger for the next 30, 40, 50 years. Many of us miss Martin, but I think we all have a sense of obligation as well. He created an amazing company and we just have to take it to the next level, and that's our responsibility.
It is time for us to take a short break, but the conversation will continue on the other side of this break. You don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. Welcome back. You're watching Storyboard, and we are in conversation with John Seifert, Chief Executive Worldwide Ogilvy. Before slipping into a break, we spoke to him about the new structure for the agency and what it meant for the employees and clients. The conversation with him continues as we talk to him about what Sir Martin Sorrell's exit from WPP meant for Ogilvy. He also spoke to us about what will the future look like for this agency and how are they keeping David Ogilvy's vision alive. Let's take a look. You spoke about competition, and currently your competition is not just the Leo Burnetts or the McCanns of the world. It's you're facing a stiff competition from the technology companies, from the consultants. What, according to you, is your biggest threat today?
Well, I think our biggest threat is relevance. As we have new competitors come in and offer different things, sometimes promising that they can do what we do, true or not true, we have to be relevant in a very dynamic, very fast-changing environment. clients are more demanding than ever because the consumer and their customers are more demanding of them. So, you know, the first thing is be relevant. And for us, relevance begins and ends with creativity. We have to apply creativity in everything we do, not just the creative product, but in how we think, how we bring in new skills, be they technology or data or production. We have to apply creativity in all the new ways in which communications are created and brands are built. And I think if we do that, we will continue to be, not only do I think we'll be a leading brand, but we'll be a company that clients know they need to do business with and value. But if we lose, you know, we lose focus on creativity as the thing that really differentiates us, we'll have a tough time.
Okay, John, this is your third visit to the country as a CEO. What brings you to India?
India is now the beacon of our transformation. It's in a market where we have always had an amazing creative reputation. We have always had phenomenal leadership, who were not just great leaders within India, they were among the most respected leaders in the company worldwide. And I now, seeing the growth in India, seeing the pace of change in India, and seeing this, the diversity of our client base, our talent, this is a market where I think it will show the way to the future for the rest of the network. And so one of the commitments I made when I launched our next chapter transformation nearly 2.5 years ago, is I said, I just had in my head that India was going to be the place where if we did it right here, it would be a showcase for the rest of the world. What I have seen the last 2 days is so inspiring because we have a group of people who've taken the strategy, they've made it their own, they're applying it in the ways that are necessary and unique for India, but it's a model that the rest of the world can follow. And I will be coming back often to make sure that they continued on the trajectory that.
Well, I hope to see you that often. On that note, I wanted to ask you how much percentage of revenue does India contribute to your global?
India is our fifth largest market in the world. Our top 20 markets represent about 85% of the total company. So if we can use India as a benchmark for the top 20 markets and the rest of those businesses perform as well as India, I will be a very successful chief executive. So I'm counting on India.
So, you know, we have our elections coming up in 2019. And, you know, in the last elections to get Modiji elected, Ogilvy played an important role. What do you think of the upcoming elections for the country, and what is going to be Ogilvy's role for that?
Well, I'm never a prognosticator on what's going to happen, but I would say that I think any election now, whether it's in India or anywhere else in the world, has become incredibly important, because what all these elections start to define is how countries want to not only lead their own citizens, but how they want to be connected to the rest of the world. I was in Davos in January and saw Prime Minister Modi speak, and I thought what was amazing about him is that, you know, he talked about an open India, and his comment was, just when the rest of the world seems like it's closing up, India is opening up. And for me, I think that's a very important direction for the country. It's a very important direction for the world.
You spoke about complexity, and we know that there's a lot of complexity around when it comes to advertising and marketing. Where are we headed to? You know, are we headed to integration, or whether we'll see more specialists coming up in the future?
I think it's both. I think that there will continue to be a need for more specialists as our industry becomes more precise, as data plays a bigger role in how everything works, as new forms of technology change the lives of our consumer. And so I think specialist capabilities will continue to grow. However, if they don't work together, if they aren't connected in a what we now call a whole brand way, they're not going to be effective. And every client that I speak to is now trying to transform their own organization to make sure that their brand, their business, their engagement with their audiences, be they consumer customers or all of the stakeholders they have to serve, is deeply connected. Because what the world is now looking to is, we're so transparent that if you don't act in a way that is true to what you say, you know, you do or what you think your value is, then you will be discounted. And so integration is critical to, I think, extract the value that brands and businesses are going to need to deliver. Okay. And so it's going to be an integrated world with a lot of specialist skills.
Okay, finally, what are Ogilvy's big plans for the future, for the coming days, and how is it going to stay true to the vision of David Ogilvy?
Well, the essence is that. We need to make sure that everything we are doing is staying true to the vision, the purpose I've outlined, but also to the view that David had, which is you are always changing. David had this amazing ability to look around the corner and see the future faster. And so we have to be a company that can see the future faster than others and start to adapt our talent, our skills, our tools to be able to perform in a very future-driven way. And if we can start to show clients that we can help them get to the future faster, they will see us as a more valued business partner, and that is the secret to our growth. And at the end of the day, we believe that creativity applied in all these new ways that our modern marketing world presents will be the thing that really differentiates us.
All right, thank you so much. Thanks for speaking to us, and congratulations on your 70 years.
Thank you very much.